It's been a punishing day for commuters as the extreme weather caused havoc across the transport network. Train, bus and ferry passengers all faced extensive delays as drivers dealt with road closures due to flooding.
It was never going to be an easy Monday morning commute given the trail of destruction across Sydney, packed station platforms and slow-moving trains, enormous bus queues.
Every service was affected in some way, whether it was flooding at Central or flooding at Newcastle. We not only saw services disrupted, but station services, even Opal readers not working because of the flooding.
A landslip at Artarmon caused major delays further up and down the line.
I sat on the train platform at Warunga for about 45 minutes. Three trains got cancelled.
Here, a camera captures the tracks at Bardwell Park Station being fully submerged by water. Flooding in the metro tunnels near Macquarie Park forced long queues of commuters onto buses. And so, right in the middle of the morning peak, there was no metro between Chatswood and Macquarie Park. Add to that a reduced service on the North Shore and Western lines and buses between Lidcombe and Olympic Park. Worst affected, though, just outside Sydney, with several lines suffering severe damage. At Lura and the Blue Mountains, a massive landslide left the tracks hanging in mid-air, halting services.
The noise was frightening. I've never been so scared in my life.
And it won't be a quick fix.
That will take out the Blue Mountains line west of Springwood all the way to Bathurst, probably for a number of days, if not longer than that.
And for drivers, not much better. Among the many roads blocked across Sydney because of flooding, Western Sydney was hard hit, catching some off guard. The Great Western Highway was closed at St Mary's, while in the north, the Wakehurst Parkway is also blocked between Narrabeen and Oxford Falls. With traffic lights still out across the city today, police stepped in to direct at major intersections.
And all of that flowed onto the NRMA. Since Friday, it's received 7,000 calls for assistance, a 30% increase on what it would typically expect over a similar period.
People are flying through puddles, and so they're getting flooding in the engine, or they're hitting a pothole because they can't see the pothole and causing a flat tyre. The other is batteries, because people run in and out of their cars quickly in the rain and leave their lights on.
And with patrols also struggling to negotiate flooded or blocked roads, drivers faced 3 to 4 hour delays for help. Eddie Meyer, Nine News.
And Nine's Danielle Post is tracking the evening commute at Central Station. Danielle, how's the network coping tonight?
Pete, it's a frustrating trip home for a lot of our commuters with major delays right across the network. The worst affected is the Metro Northwest line, and these pictures just into the newsroom show a bottleneck of commuters at Chatswood and Macquarie University, where buses are replacing trains in that area due to flooding. The North Shore and Western line, as well as the Eastern Suburbs line, commuters are being told to be patient. Also delays there because of flooding, as well as landslips along the track. And buses are also replacing trains along the Olympic Park line, the South Coast line and the Blue Mountains, while no trains are running at all on the Cumberland line. So a frustrating trip to work and a slow trip home tonight. Let's hope the reprieve in the weather will improve conditions tomorrow morning.
Danielle, thank you.